Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. This is our episode 147, Prevent the Current Sheet Name in Formulas. Hey, look, Mike and I recorded this live out at Highline. We never actually discussed what the problem is, though. So here's the problem. I'm on a sheet called Mr. Excel. I need to build a formula that is pointing to some references out on the table sheet. And so in the SUMIFS, the sum range is from table, the criteria range 1 is from table. But then when I click on East, they're using the sheet name, even though this is the current sheet. So we're trying to figure out a way to enter this formula, preventing the sheet name from appearing. The same thing's going to happen here when I go grab the products, comma, and then come back to Mr. Excel. As soon as I click on A4, which they should just put A4 here, see they've already said it's on Mr. Excel A4. So we're trying to come up with a formula, way of entering that formula to prevent the Mr. Excel sheet name there and there. All right. Well, it's Friday. It must be time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'm here with
Excel is Fun.
Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. We're live at Highline Community College. This is our episode 147, How to Avoid Sheet Reference Syntax from the Current Sheet. So here's our situation. I'm on the sheet, and we want to come up with a total formula. Then we have to look back at another sheet. And this is one of these things where I'm going to be building several different arguments that are going to be pointing at this sheet. And if I just start to do it the normal way, equals SUMIFS, it says it wants the sum range. So I head off here to the table and specify my sum range, Control Shift down arrow, comma, and now it wants criteria range 1, but I don't even remember what the original data was. I need to go back. And so I'm just going to escape out of this, and instead I'm going to do View, New Window, and then View, Arrange All, Vertical. Now on the left side, I can see the original data. On the right side, I can see the table. All right, so now I can see everything that I need on here on the screen. So we start out with equal SUMIFS. And when it asks me for the sum range, I just click over here, Control Shift down arrow, comma. Then it needs to know the criteria range. So we're going to look for product is next. So Control Shift down arrow. Nope, missed. Control Shift down arrow. I want to make sure that I start in row 2 because this criteria range has to match that range. Comma is equal to this product here. First click selects that window. Second click selects the right thing.
That is cool.
And then criteria range 2, that's going to be region. So we click over here from B2, Control Shift down arrow, comma, and then come back to East. All right, so a couple of advantages here. Advantage number 1 is I get to see both sets of data that I'm dealing with. Product first and then region. Probably wouldn't have mattered, but you know, at least I know which columns to highlight. And then benefit number 2 is that we are not getting this A4 and this B4 does not have the sheet reference name before it. So good way to go there with the view, new window, and then arrange all. Mike?
Yeah, very nice. I use that trick often when I'm creating formulas between lots of sheets. All right, I'm going to close this one right here. So Zach Barisi taught me this trick. Are you kidding me? Some ifs. Control A to open the arguments, or some ifs, Shift F3. And the sum range, now check this out. I can just zip back and forth. And I'm going to Control Shift down arrow. And now when I go back to the sheet, boom, tab. Now I'm back on this sheet. Oh, I need to go back over there. That's OK. I'm in the criteria 1. I'm going to go over to the table, Control Home. And in the region, Control Shift down arrow, tab. Criteria, and watch this. I think I did, yeah, B, that's region, no sheet reference. I love it. The sheet references are up here, but not there. Using this dialog box totally helps with that problem. All right, criteria range 2 is going to be the product. So I'll go back over here, Control Home, Control Shift down arrow, tab. And now I simply click on the criteria.
That is
Control
a slick,
Enter.
Slick trick. All right, wow.
You know, here's a crazy way I usually do this to avoid them. I just go comma, comma, get the criteria 1, which is going to be this, comma, comma, and then criteria 2 is region, close parentheses, and then I go over, and it's hard to remember which. All right, so there you go.
All right, well, that was good. I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel.
And Excel is fun.